The Director of Public Prosecutions, Jane Francis Abodo, made the appeal while appearing before Parliament's Finance Committee, where she decried the selective enhancement of salaries within the justice, law and order sector that saw judicial officers walk away with hefty pay while casting other players in the industry aside.
It's public knowledge that the employment income of judicial officers is exempt from taxation. That was under a case that they brought way back in 2005.
While defending the request of tax exemption, Abodo argued that the work of the public prosecutor directly contributes to the peace and security of the country by ensuring that the laws designed for the protection and preservation of security of persons and property are enforced.
As well as officers of court, they are the wheels of the criminal justice system, without which I think the criminal justice system will grind to an abrupt halt if the prosecutors are not there.
She revealed that due to the meager pay at the DPP, many staff are abandoning work in preference for lucrative deals in the judiciary. Abodo also admitted that she has applied thrice to the Judicial Service Commission to be posted as a judge, and that her actions aren't any different from her team members who approach her on a daily basis to sign recommendation letters for secondment of jobs in the judiciary.
The rate of staff turnover at ODPP is very high, Honorable Chair and Honorable Members. Everyone seated here, and I mean everyone seated here, with the exception of the Undersecretary, has applied to the judiciary, not once, including myself, not once, not twice, three, four times. So this is really serious.
The government is likely to lose 6.8 billion shillings in taxes should the tax exemption succeed, although this figure is disputed by the Ministry of Finance, which warned that the tax waiver is likely to cost about 7.5 billion shillings. Abodo accused the Ministry of Finance of defying the presidential directive to give prosecutors tax waivers.
It is important to bring out the financial implication for the tax waiver.
Yes.
It would come to a total of 627 879 556.
You can just compare the 6.8 to so many, to the 2.8 trillions that we forego in this country.
Some committee members backed the request, saying it will boost the morale of state prosecutors while carrying out their duties.
Now, if you treat them separately, it demotivates them. Not necessarily the financial gain they would get for the, but at least for that motivation.
This institution is the cornerstone of peace and security in this country. They are asking for a peanut. Colleagues, let's not behave like a parent who has children, they are starving at home, but the little food they have, they give the neighbors.
However, others expressed their reservations on the request for tax exemption, wondering why the state prosecutors who made two requests of salary enhancement and tax exemptions don't settle for one of the two items.
For us, is to agitate for your, for your salary enhancement. To that level, that's why I needed an accountant who would look into that, other than getting the two, salary enhancement, then tax exemption.
Chair, you are very aware that this committee has been battling the issue of tax exemption, and we demanded that we need the list of all the companies and groups that are exempted. We have lost over 7 trillion in tax exemption.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.